I am going to teach you what is data cube and what are the different dimensions and how to generate the cuboids. In the last sessions and the last videos, I have put videos based explaining what is data warehouse and what are the types of data warehouse models, multi-tier architecture, all those things. Continuation to the multi-tier architecture, we have a data cube in our syllabus. Now we'll see what is data cube. A data warehouse is based on a multi-dimensional data model. This we all know. Why we went for data warehouse instead of operational database is that it can give multi-dimensional view of data, which helps us to do the decision making. So in order to have the multi-dimensional data, so different views of data forms a data cube. So what is data cube? It's nothing but it gives the different views in different dimensions. The data is given in the different dimensions, then it is called a data cube. A data cube such as sales allows data to be modeled and viewed in multiple dimensions. So let us take the example of sales. So the name of the data cube is sales. It is like we can compare data warehousing with the database management system. Like the table name is nothing but sales. Here in the data warehouse, the data cube, this data cube name is sales. So the table name is similar to data cube name in data warehouse. So the data cube name is sales in data warehouse. In the DBMS, it is table name. In DBMS, for every relation, for every table, we'll be having set of attributes. The set of attributes in the DBMS or operational database is called as dimensions in the data warehouse. So whatever we call as attributes in the DBMS, we will call it as dimensions. Whatever we call the table name or relation name in the DBMS, we will call it as data cube. That is the difference. Hope you would have understood better on. Yes. So if I take the sales table in DBMS, what are the attributes? So the sales, if you take sales ID, item, and the profit will keep. So these are the attributes. If you take data warehouse, for the data cube sales, the dimensions are sales ID, item name, and the profit. Like this, we can say. Yes. See, dimension tables. What is dimension table? For every attribute, we'll be having a separate table in the DBMS. You would have seen. Similarly, in the data warehouse also, for every dimension, we can create a dimension table. I said for the data cube sales, we have the attributes, or we have the dimensions called sale ID, item, and we'll mention it as item, comma profit. So for the dimension item in the data cube sales, for the data cube sales, we can have the dimension table. That's what is said here. In dimension tables such as item, so dimension table again can have certain dimensions, that is item name, brand, and type. Clear? So for the dimension table item, we have certain dimensions called item name, brand, and type, or time. Here we'll consider the dimension table is time. So for this dimension, we have dimensions called dimension table. We have day, week, month, quarter, year as a dimensions. Okay. What is fact table? Fact table contains measures such as dollars sold and keys to each of the related dimension table. So how I can calculate the profit? How I can calculate the profit is with the help of the fact table. How much dollars has been sold? So the fact table helps us to calculate the dollars sold by grouping by the dimensions. So what are the dimensions we have for the sales we have to see. See, for example, we will have we will take the sales table, sales fact table. So in the sales fact table, let us assume that we have four attributes. As I said, item, sale ID, item name, then instead of profit, I'll mention here as dollars sold. Okay, so sale ID, item name, dollars sold. These are the three dimensions of the fact table called sales. Fact table is sales, we can call it as data keywords. Okay, for the fact table sales, we have three dimensions. One is item name, then sale ID, item name, and the dollars sold. So how I'm going to calculate the dollars sold is either with respect to sale ID or with or I can group it by item. So what are the possibilities of grouping? If I see, first grouping is I can group by either sale ID or I can group by item name. Item name, or I can group by both the dimensions called sale ID and item name. So how I will get the data, that is dollars sold, is how I am going to measure the dollars sold is by grouping the dimensions, such as first sale ID, either only with the sale ID or only with the item name, or with the item name as well as the sale ID. So these are the three possible dimensions I can have. So how many number of cuboids I can generate is, so what are the number of attributes three dimensions we said, such as item, sale ID, item name, and the dollar sold. Here we are going to measure the dollar sold, we should not take that. So apart from that, this measure, I have to take the other dimension called sale ID and the item name. So the number of dimensions is 2 here. So 2 power 2 is equal to 4 cuboids can be generated. So 4 possible attributes can be generated. The first dimension is only with respect to sale ID, I can calculate the dollar sold, or I can group by item name and calculate the dollar sold, or I can group by item name as well as the sale ID and I can find the dollar sold, or without anything. So these are the four attributes. So 2 power 2 is the formula to calculate the number of cuboids that can be generated for a data cube. So the lattice of cuboids forms a cube. What is lattice? Group of cuboids. So how many number of cuboids I can generate? As I said, 4. 2 power 2 is equal to 4, because I have two dimensions apart from this dollars sold. So 2 power 2 is equal to 4. 4 number of cuboids can be generated. If you combine all the 4 cuboids, the collection of the 4 cuboids is called as the data cube for the fact table sales. The bottom level is called, I'll explain with this diagram. You can, yes. See, this is, if you take, this is another table. We will call this table as a sale table only. So for this, the dimensions, how many number of dimensions we have? 4 dimensions we have. One is time, item, location, supplier. What we are going to measure is dollars sold. I am going to calculate the profit or dollars sold with respect to these dimensions. So either I can calculate the dollars sold only by grouping it with time, or only with item, or only with respect to location, or only with respect to the supplier. This is the first possibility. And the second one is, I can take two attributes and I can do it. One is time comma item, or time comma location, time and location, or location and the supplier, or item and the location, or item and the supplier. Next, I can do it with respect to three. I can group it by three attributes, like time, item, location, or time, item, supplier, or time, location, supplier. These are the three possible combinations. for 3 dimensions. We want to take all the 4 dimensions, then time, item, location, supplier. Since we have to calculate the dollars sold with respect to the dimensions, 4 dimensions, so what is the formula? 2 power n. 2 power n means what is n? Number of dimensions. How many number of dimensions we have to calculate the dollars sold? We have 4 dimensions. So 2 power 4 is equal to 16. 16 are nothing but the possible number of combinations. See, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. In the first 0D apex cuboid, nothing will be there. It is empty. It is empty, so it is apex cuboid. And if you are going to take all the 4 dimensions, you are going to group by all the 4 dimensions to calculate the dollars sold, then this base cuboid. So empty means 0 dimension. So in the second level, I am taking only 1 dimension, so it is called 1D cuboid. In the third level, I am taking 2 dimensions, so it is 2 dimensional cuboid. The third level, 3D cuboids, since I have taken 3 dimensions, and 4D base cuboid, since I have taken 4 dimensions here. So all these cuboids, like 16 cuboids, will form a data cube called sales. That is called lattice of cuboids. Lattice of cuboids will form a cube. So how many number of cuboids can be generated? 16 cuboids can be generated with the 4 dimensions. So this is how we can form a cuboid, and this is data cube which contains number of dimensions on the dimension table. Hope you would have understood better. Thank you.